Welcome to RIA Awakening. I am Ace Young. I am going to be joined for the first half of this show by H.M Archer. My God, what a show we have. We are here on Long Island, New York, J.A. Money's backyard.
Yes, you are right. And think, the first pay-per-view of RISKITALL Wrestling so soon. This could be interesting.
This is going to be a hell of a match. Leon London taking on Ian Fox for the RIA Intercontinental title.
Now, I won't lie, I was trying to get word from Leon London on how he's feeling about this match and his strategy for Ian Fox, but I couldn't get a single word off him. I guess he doesn't want anyone to know his strategy whatsoever, but so you can already imagine that this is going to be a good fight.
Yeah, I mean, if I was Leon, I wouldn't want to tip my hand either.
Nope, you are not wrong there, my friend. You are not wrong there. Think, these two being former teammates, well, I mean, not really, but they both have a similar connection. So, you gotta admit, maybe, like, they might hold back on one another. They might go all out. You can't tell.
Yeah, I can't wait to see what happens here. Leon is actually I have to say it's a surprising challenger, but he won the number one contenders match, so here we are.
You are correct.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and is for the Intercontinental Championship.
And here comes the challenger, Leon London, looking confident.
Yeah, he seems very energetic. He's definitely pandering to the crowd a bit. I would not expect that from him.
Yeah, he's definitely got a little bit of a swagger here tonight.
But you gotta know, maybe that little cocky and arrogance just means he's ready. I wonder how will Ian Fox be prepared for someone that's pretty much, I gotta say, he's unpredictable.
Yeah, we don't know too much about Leon London. He's relatively new here to RIA, and we're gonna find out what he's made of here tonight. This is a big match for him, obviously the biggest of his career.
Yeah, I think back then, we only seen him have a couple matches against Dragon Wind, and now, after winning a successful Fatal 4-Way match, he is here to become a champion.
Yeah, and that's going to be a really tall task, because here comes the RIA Intercontinental Champion, Ian Fox, and look at him, he is hyped.
I gotta say, that Intercontinental Championship looks really good on Ian Fox right now.
It definitely does.
And this is his first defense, so you know he has to be focused, and you know he needs this to retain. He just needs this.
Oh, absolutely he does. There's a lot of people who feel like you're not a champion until you make your first successful defense. So we're gonna find out a lot here tonight.
As far as we know, the only one that has successfully retained their respective title is JA on two different occasions. So Ian is definitely looking to be one of the others to actually retain successfully.
Yeah, no, we're gonna see JA Money try to retain his world title again later tonight for a third time in a last man standing against Broxton Apier.
Weighing in at 220 pounds, Sub-Zero, Leon.
Can't really get a feel for who the crowd is behind here. I mean, seems like a bit of a split.
He is the...
Yeah, it's a little even between both, so you don't know who the crowd is pandering for.
Leon London looking at his title possibly for the final time.
See. I got to say, I am just excited, and here we go.
Here we go indeed. There's the bell. Start off with a nice little collar and elbow tie up here.
Yeah, these two know each other pretty well.
Let's see if we get a clean break. Oh, and we do. Super kick.
Starting off on a really good impression.
Nice.
DDT and a kip up.
Yeah, we all know I love a good kip up.
Me too. But we also know you love a good super kick as well.
What can I say? The Heartbreak Kid was my favorite wrestler.
Understandable. Alright, what is Ian Fox about to do?
Oh, he's got some bad intentions here. Oh my god,
that could not feel well for Leon London.
Absolutely not. My god. Oh, now he's going to work on the leg. Indian deathlock here by Ian Fox.
Leon is very close to the ropes. Why isn't he grabbing it?
I don't know. Maybe the heat of the moment, the big spot. Oh, super kick to the midsection.
Oh, but that must have woken Leon. Hurricanrana!
Beautiful Hurricanrana.
Jawbreaker.
Added. Oh, nice.
Single leg drop kick, I believe.
Yes, it was. Snapmare. Claw on his eyes.
Was ready for that. Up on the shoulders.
Ushigaroshi. Catches the foot. Nice.
Perverse
spinning up here. Yeah.
Very evenly matched so far. Yeah, that's up on the shoulders again.
Another
Ushigaroshi
one.
Ushigaroshi number two. But Leon's just back up.
Oh, super kick. Nice. Standing.
The shooting star press.
Beautiful standing shooting star by Leon London. Oh, and a pump kick to the face by Ian Fox.
Let's return the favor.
He's going up on the top. Oh, the kip up. Might have been playing possum there. I don't know why Ian jumped. Beautiful.
But that was incredible. I'm very shook. European uppercut. Wow.
Ian just punches him right in the mouth.
Apparently he calls that the Rex Kwon Do. He's going for the cover.
In the middle of the ring, one, two. And a kick out by Leon London.
To think if that would have been it.
Would have been a big title defense for Ian Fox.
Yep. Tattoo in reverse.
One, two. And a kick out by Leon London at two. Kick out of that?
I know.
Kick
we've out seen Ian Fox successfully win the title with that move, but
yes,
it didn't
we
work
have.
On Leon.
Leon has now kicked out of the Rex Kwon Do and the tattooed in reverse. Slingshot neck breaker. Ian rolls him up. One, two.
That was too close.
Almost caught Leon London sleeping.
DDT. What a kick up.
He just said, fuck yo, DDT.
Oh,
super kick. Leon wisely rolling out of the ring.
Yeah, but Anthos is right out on his tail. No, how will Leon bounce? Ooh, we got some color.
Yes, we do. Oh, a snap suplex. Float over. One, two. Oh.
Not enough to take Leon down.
No, it was not. Has him up. Oh, drops him right on his dome piece.
Yep.
Super kick. Oh.
And a suplex.
Beautiful straight jacket German suplex by Ian Fox going for the cover here. One. Two and a kick out by Leon London again.
What is Ian going to do? No matter every answer that he's had, Leon just counters it.
Oh, a deadlift German.
Not bad from Leon.
Super kick. Oh, he caught the foot. Capture exploding suplex. Oh, he's setting up.
He's setting him up.
Rex Kwando again, possibly. Oh, no. Oh!
Back to black.
That's gotta be it.
There's no way.
One, two, and that'll do it. Ian Fox successfully defends his Intercontinental title.
Gotta say, that was very impressive. It took so much to get Leon London down, but I guess Ian Fox just knew he had to go for everything in order to take down Leon London.
Oh, he definitely, he pulled out all the tricks here.
You know, Rex Kwando, tattoo in reverse, back to black. What? It took all that to take down Leon London.
Yeah, Leon London was very, very game tonight, but in the end, it was Ian Fox defending his IC title.
It makes you wonder, who is next for the still Intercontinental Champion?
Yeah, I'm sure we're gonna find that out in the coming weeks. And, all right, coming up next, we've got Vickie Cloud taking on Pam in a tables match.
Ooh, one of the big rivalries between two different people, Vickie Cloud and Pam. Ooh, you know, Pam was itching for this match to happen.
Oh, she was. You know what? I know we're not supposed to take sides, but I'm really hoping Vickie Cloud drives Pam right through a table.
It would really put RISKITALL on notice, especially if Vickie Cloud could put Pam through a table. But if Pam was to do the opposite, I would hate to be anyone that has to face her next.
Oh yeah, me too. Oh, man. We all know, though, Pam is very well-versed with tables. She's usually laying on them, but,
yeah, that
I'll just
is
leave it at that.
Very true.
Alright, well, here comes the owner of RIA, Vickie Cloud.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think after last week with that mixed tag match, you got to imagine she feels like she needs to put the hurt on Pam. Take on the snitch that steals snitches.
Yeah, last week's mixed tag match main event. There are really no words. I have to consider it an upset.
Oh, without a doubt, definitely. But I think she's ready to be deemed last week, and she's ready to put the hurt on Pam.
We're gonna find out in a minute here. But she definitely looks very focused here tonight.
I agree. Oh, but here she is.
Here comes the big dairy farmer. My God, look at her.
No training needed. All she needs to do is beat a couple of heads, and she is ready for a fight.
Oh, absolutely.
Makes you wonder, how many beers did this girl drink? Because that could really come into effect.
I don't even want to take a guess. I'm guessing she polished off at least a six pack.
Yeah, I can see a six. Definitely see a six pack.
And there we go. Bell.
Oh. All right. The crowd's already getting some offense in.
Oh!
Didn't think I'd see that happen.
No, me either. Especially not this early.
Yep, and a body slam from Pam.
Oh. Punch right to the midsection. Last call for alcohol. Fall away slam.
Oh. And catches Vickie Cloud's
kick. Oh, no.
Oh. Hoist her up. And a big boot.
Pam. Going to the top rope.
Oh,
drops a knee right on Vickie Cloud. My God.
That didn't feel good.
Oh, now she's just going to step right on top of her.
The disrespect.
Complete disrespect. Oh, man. Uh-oh. Round and round, she goes where she stops, only Vickie Cloud knows.
Okay.
Beautiful spinning head scissors. What is Vickie going to do here? Drives her face first into the mat.
Yeah.
Super kick.
That's one way to bounce back.
Yeah, it is. Sends her to the rope.
Face buster.
Knee to face. Oh, and the kick is good, right between the uprights. Sidewalk slam.
Right.
A jawbreaker.
Yeah. Oh, God, very back and forth between these two.
It really is.
Yep. Another box slam.
Pam's going for the table.
Table time.
Oh, man.
That didn't take long.
Oh, what is she doing here? She's going to go out after her.
Yes, she is.
Oh, and a backbreaker on the outside.
Right to the back. Keep out. Throws Pam back in.
And what is she? We saw this last week, too. Why?
Did she not learn?
Oh, my God. Why would she do that again?
No disrespect to Mr. Amazing, but if Pam would have just took advantage of that and threw her into a table, that would literally be two for your mistakes.
It definitely would. Oh!
Oh my God! right onto the steel steps, I think.
Oh, and a headbutt.
Oh,
and another backbreaker. Really going to work on that lower back of Vickie Cloud.
This is just a field day for Pam right now. And just going to throw her.
Sends her back in the ring.
Yep.
You know, it's gonna be interesting later on when Vicky joins me on commentary, and I'm gonna ask her about sitting down right in front of Pam.
All you can do is just get their thoughts. That's pretty much it and all.
Nice.
Now, I know it's definitely impossible, but if the table broke at that, that would have been the worst way to end that match.
Oh my god, I know.
Uh-oh.
Northern Lights on the table. Oh. And oh, man.
Ooh.
What offense by Vickie Cloud.
Pam bounces back.
What is she going to do here?
I don't know.
Oh, elbow to the face.
I guess nothing.
Oh, a brain buster.
Ooh. Very nice brain buster from the boss.
Oh, man. Ooh. Just punched her right in the mouth.
Yeah. I think some of the blood got on her.
Last call for alcohol.
Oh, she's setting up the table.
This is not good for Vickie Cloud.
No, it is not. Will Vickie Cloud be able to bounce back?
Oh, alley-oop!
Oh, and the table's down again.
Yeah, I think Vickie caught a break on that one. Oh, what a brainbuster on the table!
Very nice.
Vickie now setting the table up in the corner. Yeah, that's a wiser move.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, oh. Vicky's got some... Oh. Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, my God!
Oh, my God!
Ultra-violence indeed!
She just not locked Pam on her head!
You know, if the table had been out there, that would have been it.
Yeah. Uh-oh. And now she's going to break the arm.
Oh! My God. Oh, Vickie gets set into the steel steps.
Ooh.
What should we do here?
Just
throw her into the barricade.
What is Pam going to do? Oh no!
Oh
my god!
Oh my god, Vickie Cloud is literally broken in half.
That is her back, that is the barricade, Everything is broken.
Oh man.
Jesus Christ. Right.
How are either of these two still alive at this point?
I don't know.
Oh, Vickie gives her an elbow.
Throws her.
What are you doing? Win the damn match first.
Time to breathe. One thing I say is she probably needed some time to breathe. Oh. Back in the ring they go. Uh-oh.
Ooh!
Ooh!
That's a big-ass tree trunk coming down on top of Vickie Cloud.
Uh-oh. Pam with the table.
Pam looking to end this right now.
Vickie Cloud better stop him.
Ooh. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Oh!
desperation right there.
What was that?
Effective. That's what that was.
Oh, she did the better than Broxton. Oh my God. Oh. But it just wasn't better than Pam. Choke slam. Oh my God. I am in just such disbelief. That was insane.
Here is your winner.
To think, Pam actually predicted that? Oh my God. She did exactly what she said she was going to do.
And coming up next, we have the RIA Tag Team Championships on the line in a triple threat tornado tag match. We've got the new champions, Dominance Personified, taking on the former champions, Young Love, and a very formidable tag team of Evil Rage.
Yeah, I gotta say, I would hate to be Kid right now with all these giants.
Yeah, oh man. Look, all these guys are just huge, and then you have poor Kid who's like, what, 5-something, a buck 20.
Yeah, pretty much. It's like you have a 7-footer, got some 6'6", 6'9" guys, and then you just have Kid. 5'6".
Hey, I mean, if Rey Mysterio has taught us anything, it's not the size of the dog in the fight.
It's how it could survive.
Yeah.
I mean, we have seen some crazy underdog stuff happen before.
We have.
Can Young Love get back the titles, or will? Will Domination Personified retain, or will we see new champs in these non-human bastards?
You know what? I got a bit of a soft spot for Young Love.
I can understand that. They have been a very interesting tag team.
Yes, they have.
You gotta admit, Big Trust and Jay Stone, they are quite the unit, especially how they won in convincing fashion.
Oh, definitely. Definitely, 100%. And here come the RIA Tag Team Champions, Dominance Personified.
Yeah?
I don't say these two look very ready.
Yeah, they're definitely looking confident here.
I'm guessing these two did not want to enter with their titles. I guess they wanted to like make it feel as though like, all right, you know, we're all fighting for this. We don't need to wear our titles so they know that we're champs. They already know we are.
A little bit of heat from the crowd. I guess they don't really like these guys after last week. Yeah, it doesn't sound like it.
Hey, they had a chance. You got this.
Uh-oh. It's dark. It's hot.
It is very spooky.
This is.
I don't know if this was in the budget, but okay.
Oh my god. Look at these two. Evil rage.
So long. Wow. What are these guys?
I don't know. I don't know.
I say this every time, and I'm gonna keep saying this. Are these guys human?
I don't think so. Oh man. And they are taking their they are taking their sweet ass time to get to the ring too. They are in no hurry.
I ain't gonna tell them to hurry. You wanna tell them?
Definitely not. I'm needed here.
Just look at Tanny. He is over 7 feet the size of this guy.
Yeah, Danny Hunter is 7'4".
Jesus Christ, how?
Justin Rage is about 7 feet himself.
Oh, these are just some super heavyweights ready to become champions. They surprisingly.
Oh no! We're not done yet. I don't think. We're gonna get more. Oh, here it comes!
What?
Here it comes! Yeah, Jesus! Man.
All right. I think I'm out. Vickie, are you ready? No, she's not ready yet. Okay.
And here come Lance Roman, Ed Kidd, Young Love. Oh man.
It's crazy to see that these two still walk together in hands. It feels weird that they're not champions.
That might all change after tonight.
Yeah, well, who knows? I mean, like I said, oh my god, Kid looks like a... Oh my god, Kid just looks like a small chihuahua compared to these mastiffs.
Oh, yes he does.
Oh my god.
Look at
just
the
looking
size
at him right next
difference.
To Danny Hunter.
Oh man.
It's ridiculous.
And Lance just brushing right past Justin Rage.
Yeah, well, like, it's like what you would say. Lance
this
is a big boy.
This is going to be a cluster.
God,
oh my god, Kid going right after Danny Hunter.
Oh my god. And kicking J-Stone.
And now Amir. Kid's just going after everybody.
I know. What?
Uh-oh. Ooh, Danny Hunter's so big. I don't even think the kick connected.
Who knows?
I think
powerbomb with J-Stone.
My god, look at the size there. Oh god. Amir is.
Why would he do that? Especially with, like, all these giants and Kid.
I mean, they didn't make him pay for it, so.
Fair enough.
I mean, if that was me, this type of match, I go grab a chair and I waffle him with it.
You know, besides Kid, the one I really feel bad for is this referee. I mean, look at him compared to all of these guys.
Yeah.
He is Kid level height.
Yes, he is. Oh, what is Kid I don't know what the hell Kid was trying to do there.
I don't know, but it wasn't going to work.
No, it was not. Look at this. There is no place for this ref to go.
Oh,
a nice belly-to-belly by Amir. And
the strength of Big Trust. Oh my god.
Yeah, he's definitely a powerhouse. Oh, it just a close onto the back of Kid's head.
Right. Well, looks like Domination Personified has taken control of the ring.
Yes, they have. Oh no. Oh, poor Kid. That didn't even faze him.
These non-human freaks, my god. Big boots!
Torture rack!
Danny Hunter should not be able to move that quick. My god, what is this man? Even is a man, I don't know.
This man is a machine, I think.
Probably.
Oh! Devil juice!
Jesus Christ!
Just spit that devil juice right in Kid's face. Oh no, he's going for a big ride. Oh dang, setting him up.
What is this going to be?
J-Stone stopped it.
Blocks it. J-Stone may have saved Kid's life.
He did 100% saved Kid's life.
Oh, dragon screw leg whip from J-Stone.
Oh man. Oh, close on into the corner by Danny.
There's all these giants. Alley oop from Danny.
And belly to back.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Lance is on a ride.
And now, just like that, it's evil rage in control. Oh.
A little bit of a
little miscommunication there. Just punches Big Trust right in the face. Fujiwara by Lance.
Oh, saved by current champion.
Justin just dropped Kid right on his face.
Jesus, the heights.
Going for the cover. And Lance breaks it up.
Saves.
Keeping Young Love in this match.
I have no idea what just happened.
You know what? I've lost control of this match.
I think we all have.
This poor referee.
The ref is down too.
There is nowhere for him to go in this match. Like, he's just
there. He is just. I don't know what you can call it.
I don't know.
Oh my god.
Armbar by Kid.
And what is J-Stone doing?
He's not doing a thing.
I don't know why J-Stone didn't stop that.
I don't either.
Mirror flex.
And a kick out by Danny Hunter.
That would have been it. J-Stone surviving from that big boot.
This is out of control. You know what? I think Lance is looking for the Bronco Buster, but I don't think he's gonna hit it in this kind of match. Not when you have everybody in there at the same time. Oh no! Powder slam! Ropes
just
saved it.
For the ropes.
We
just
almost had
little.
New champions.
Almost. Oh my god. That was a little interesting.
It was.
Oh.
Oh, the power of Jay Stone.
Oh, he tried. He really tried.
Oh,
what is the big truss about to go for?
Oh, nothing. Justin just punches him right in the mouth. Has him up. Oh, what a power bomb.
Power bomb.
Oh, poor kid is now in there with the land of the giants.
Yep. Oh, combination from Big Truss.
Oh, sit out power bomb by Jay Stone.
Oh. Near try, but he just couldn't get the big guy up.
What the?
Oh.
Oh my God.
He should not be moving that quick.
Oh man.
Oh, now we're just working on the tag champ.
Uh-oh. Choke slam. Oh.
Oh. Oh. And they're going for the pin. Or they're not.
No. Kids on top of him. Two. Oh. Oh my God. Oh my God.
He almost stole it.
Oh my God.
That was so close. That would have been an upset.
100% agreed.
My God. Uh-oh. What's Jay Stone going for?
Oh, nice, Hurricanrana.
Oh, nice.
Oh. Snake eyes.
Right.
Oh my God.
Didn't expect that. Power bomb.
Lance in the corner.
Oh,
Tequila Sunrise.
Okay. Big Truss better stop him.
Oh, that's one way to do it.
That is one way. Poor ref. I swear, I think he's gonna need a pay raise after this match.
I think so.
But knowing Vickie Cloud, not happening.
Oh no.
Oh no.
No!
Oh my God!
One! Two!
Why?
Oh my God! Oh my God!
What just happened?
God help Risk It All Wrestling. Oh my God.
I am in disbelief.
Oh man.
What just happened?
Here are your winners.
This is what just happened. The referees wanted to get the hell out of Dodge.
I would too.
Those titles look like toys in their hands.
Oh my God.
God help RIA.
Tag team wrestling is going to be a war.
God help RIA. But coming up next, the Bloodsport Championship is on the line as Dark Silence takes on Kazama.
Bloodsport is something that we're going to be doing every Monday, and it's going to be interesting,
to say the least.
Yeah, to think, and we're crowning our inaugural champion with two major rivals, Dark Silence and Kazama. Kazama, he is itching for a win. Dark Silence, he is itching to just take the head of Kazama's finally and claim gold.
Yeah, if there was a time for Kazama to get his first win, this is definitely it.
Yes. Oh, let's imagine. This championship is... They're fighting for this via Bloodsport rules, am I correct?
Yeah, you are correct.
Okay, well, for those who don't know how Bloodsport works, it's 30 minutes. There's no disqualifications, there's no countouts, there's no rope breaks whatsoever. The only way you can win is by knocking out your opponent or making them tap out. KO or TKO, that's the only way you can win.
This is going to be a complete war.
Oh, I agree.
It is for the Extreme Ultra Violent Championship!
Making his way to the ring. You gotta imagine, Dark Silence is ready to add another win to his repertoire.
Yeah, he is.
But I'm very curious, what will Kazama bring? Maybe this is what he needed.
Yeah, he hasn't really fared that well here. Maybe the Bloodsport title is exactly what he needs.
Yeah, and how RISKITALL Bloodsport's gonna work is every week that title is going to be defended under Bloodsport rules. So you can be seeing multiple champions, you can be seeing a very lengthy reign. It just all depends on how much these guys put it on the line.
And here comes Kazama.
And his opponent from the edge of reality, weighing in at 265 pounds, the Punisher, Christian.
Looking for his first win.
He looks very focused. I think what Kazama really needs to do is not try to show off, not try to pander to the crowd. He needs to be 110% focused if he wants to win his first match, win his first championship in RISKITALL Wrestling, and prove that he belongs here.
Yeah, and you would have to think another loss, though, would be just crippling.
Oh, it would be detrimental. I could tell you that. And only hope is this is for the Bloodsport Championship. Let's get a look of this wild ass title.
And that is what it's all about there, folks.
Dude, was that a bullet hole in the title?
Probably.
Oh my god.
Well, there's the
when
bell.
When they say RISKITALL, they mean RISKITALL.
Oh, and a belly to belly.
30 minutes is on the clock, so these guys have 30 minutes to knock one another out. Ooh!
Just a big-ass clothesline takes down Kazama and drops a fist on him.
Kazama's bouncing back.
Ooh!
Just a small little clothesline. Gonna lift him up. Slam him to the mat.
Oh, slams the back of his head into the mat.
Yep. And a belly to belly.
Beautiful belly to belly. What does he do here?
I have no idea.
Oh, power bomb!
Very nice power bomb from Kazama.
Oh, Dark Silencer rolls down the back.
Yep.
Into the corner he goes.
Let's see, what is Dark Silencer gonna go for? Gonna go up high.
Oh, superplex coming up. Oh!
Oh!
Oh, Kazama just popped up. Oh, he's got him a bear hug. I don't know how, but he did. Oh, driving his elbows right into the head. Oh!
Mongolian chop?
Oh, Fujiwara.
Oh, but Kazama's not done that easily.
Yeah, no, Kazama quickly got out of that one.
Yes, he did.
Oh. Ooh. Going to work on the arm and the shoulder.
Oh.
Oh, just unleashing right hands.
Yes, he is. Ooh. Right to the back.
Oh!
Fuck! Eulogy! But it's not enough.
No,
it's not enough.
Could he be looking for the BBC next? Oh no, he ducked it!
Oh, that's gotta hurt.
Oh, Dark
Silence.
And
so does that.
Yes, it does. Uh-oh.
3 minutes have passed.
Oh no, he's on the shoulders. Oh, and that's gonna be it.
Wow.
that's the only thing you can say to sum it up.
Pretty much. So the inaugural champion of Bloodsport is Dark Silence.
Wow.
Yeah, we gotta figure out who's gonna fight him on Monday for the Bloodsport Championship.
We're gonna find that out later tonight.
Yeah, unfortunately, it was going to be Danny Hunter, but now that he's a tag team champion,